Welcome to the Path of a Swami podcast. My name is Swami Chidananda, and today I wanted to speak about judgment. A lot of times we are very quick to judge others, we're quick to judge the environment, we're also quick to judge ourselves. And this judgment comes from what is referred to as avidya, or ignorance of who we are. In the Vedic tradition, it states that we are the Atma and that we are eternal and that we come from that supreme divine source. Now, some might approach that aspect as a form. Some might approach it as formless. So regardless of how one approaches it, regardless of the philosophy that they belong to, ultimately we all come from one source, right? And so avidya, or ignorance, is when we have forgotten that and we believe ourselves to be separate from everything around us. And that misconception of separation is where judgment comes from. But once we start to go on the spiritual path and we start to realize the oneness, that divine is in everything, that everything comes from the divine, then it's hard to judge. Because who are we judging but ourselves when we look at situations around us? And that judgment is not just for those that are in the world, that are materialistic in nature, but judgment is also very much there in the spiritual path. And that judgment goes hand in hand with pride. So spiritual pride is one of the worst things that we can experience on the path. It's the easiest way to stop our growth. And that spiritual pride comes from thinking that we are better than somebody else. Oh, we have this guru, we have this practice, we have understanding of Vedic scriptures. Look at them, look how they're operating in the world, look what they're doing. They're terrible, we're great. When we have that type of understanding, what that goes to show is that we have knowledge, but that knowledge has not been internalized. So on the spiritual path, it's one thing to read books. It's one thing to acquire knowledge. It's another thing to internalize that knowledge. And that internalization, very, very, very few people do. Because to internalize it, you need a guru. You need some type of meditation practice, a spiritual practice that carries a certain energy to help you to transform the mind. Without having a teacher or without having a practice that carries the energy of the divine, everything will remain at a very book level understanding. So that's why there's such an emphasis on seek a true spiritual teacher, seek spiritual practices that you feel can help you to experience love. Because ultimately there's no difference between love, the divine, God, form, formless, right? So what is it that can help you to experience love? Knowledge, when we read, when we approach the Gita, it grounds our experiences, right? It gives us some type of understanding of why we're having this, and it doesn't make us fly. It allows us to harness those experiences and then do our duty so those experiences can increase over time, okay? And so that's what knowledge gives us. It gives us the ability to ground ourselves. But just knowledge without experience, it's useless. It's better off if you go and just read Harry Potter, because if you don't feel love, if you don't experience something, then it's not going to really help you. And it can even do the opposite. It can awaken spiritual pride in us that stagnates our growth. That humility is removed. So judgment is such an important thing for us to constantly reflect on. Why are we judging others? What type of experiences have we had? Are we really living the teachings that we are studying and practicing on a daily basis? And this was something that I learned the hard way when I came to New York City after living with my guru for many, many years. I had arrived during Navaratri, which was a 9-day celebration of the Divine Mother. And so Navaratri was a festival that I really enjoyed when I was in the ashram. And of course, being here in New York City, I didn't really know how to celebrate by myself. But the nice thing was that I was staying next to a church. And the church was focused on the Divine Mother, Mother Mary. And so I thought to myself, you know what, the festival is 9 days long. Every day, let me come, pray to the Divine Mother, offer a rose, and do a little walk around the church. So every day I would go and I would do this. And then on the last day, you know, I was feeling a lot of love. I was thinking to myself, oh, this is, look at me, I'm doing this every single day. Who else in New York City is doing this? Everybody else is in the bars and drinking and partying. I'm here praying to the Divine Mother every night. Right? So it's amazing how we can do something spiritual and then at the same time have so much pride. And so if we don't have a teacher in our life to call us out, if we don't have some type of grace in our life to break us from this misunderstanding, it's a very difficult situation to be put in. So thankfully for me, grace was coming in one form or another. And so at this point, on the last day, I go and I pray to the Divine Mother and I offer the rose and I do the prayers and I start to go for a walk. And as I go for the walk, I'm coming back around and I see a homeless man where I was, the place that I was at. And he had his pants down and he was urinating all over the statue of Mother Mary. He was urinating on the rose. And I was looking at this. And immediately I felt so much anger. I said, how could this be? How could this person do this? You know, so much disrespect. And that anger turned into judgment, that how can this person do this? Do they not know better? They are not spiritual. And as I was going through this whole process inside of me, very far away from experiencing the love of the Divine Mother, I look up at the statue and I see, or I perceive, that the Divine Mother is smiling at this homeless man. And there's so much love that is coming from her. And as I'm looking at this, I start to understand that we all come from the same source. Nobody is better or worse. Nobody is greater. A monk and a criminal, a homeless man and a doctor, a priest and a dog, there's no difference. We all come back, we all come from the source, we all go back to that source. And in this world, yeah, we experience duality. Some of us, for whatever reasons, might be further away from experiencing love. Some of us might be closer, but ultimately we're all going to get there because we are eternal. Love is eternal. What is 1 year? What is 1,000 years? What is 1 billion years in eternity? So in that way, we all have our experiences in this world. We all have situations that we find ourselves in. Some of us are on the path, some of us are not, but it's not for us to judge. It's for us to understand that everything is love. It's for us to help people. It's for us to pray for people, but it's ultimately for us to change. And I'm not talking about changing physically, I'm talking about changing how we see this world. And if we continue to judge, then have we really changed? And so as I saw this love that she had for the homeless man, I started to perceive things a little bit differently. I started to see that pride inside of myself. I started to see that I wasn't really living what I was preaching. And I tried to, from that moment, change a little bit. And that's always been my sort of prayer to my guru, to the Divine Mother, is, you know, help me to perceive the love of the Divine in all things. And in that, that's where judgment ceases. And of course, I'm not there. It's a daily practice to help us to get there. But I'm lucky in the sense that I have a guru and I have a practice that I know can get me there. And so in that way, if we don't have those two things, if we have one of those things, not the other, then what is it that we can do? So one thing I would say is whenever we feel judgment, try and flip it. And rather than judging that person, think about all of the things that have gotten you where you are that is making you not do something that you are judging the other person for doing. Yeah. So for me, yes, sure, what this person is doing is disrespectful to the Murti. I'm not going to sit here and say that's right and she should keep doing that. No, maybe I can say something like, hey, you know, maybe you can go somewhere else. Maybe there's another way. So there's many ways to handle it, which doesn't have to do with the emotion of judgment and anger. So for me, when I'm looking at the situation, I can say, okay, what are the things that have made me realize that this is not something that one should do? A good education, the teachings of my guru, a sane mind that allows me to operate in this world. To God's grace, I've not had any sort of mental illness or addictions that might take me away from the path. I've had a great mother that has helped to raise me in the best way possible. So in this way, I could be grateful and thankful for everything the divine has given me. And in that gratitude, then the judgment isn't there anymore. Then the love flows. And then there are ways to resolve a particular situation. But if you try to fix a situation from emotion and anger, we're just going to end up making it worse. So one thing is try your best to see and experience gratitude when you are faced with judging somebody. And secondly, dedicate your practice to them. Pray for them. Because the prayer, as I said, it doesn't have to be to a form. Pray to love. Pray to this divinity that is holding everything together and just say, please let them experience this love. Let them experience this joy that I have when I chant and do my spiritual practices. So gratitude and prayer is a great way to help us to overcome the obstacle of judgment, which ultimately leads to pride. And with pride, we're very far away from experiencing love. So with that, I hope you enjoyed this particular podcast on judgment and hope you received some tools such as gratitude and prayer that can help you to perceive it and not go into it on your path. So much love.